So we're seeing a number of changes with the way that infrastructure is being funded globally at the moment. And one of the main changes that's occurring is that governments are increasingly aware that they are unable to fund all of the requirements of their citizens for infrastructure on their own. So increasingly they're looking for creative ways that will attract private capital into infrastructure opportunities. And that is one of the significant challenges that governments are facing in all parts of the world today. So Europe's approached the need for infrastructure by not adopting a one-size-fits-all approach, as you might expect, given the different countries that we have within Europe. Some countries have followed an approach where they've provided infrastructure through just public provision, whereas other countries have relied almost entirely on private sector capital, and others have used a hybrid of the two. When it comes to North America, we're encouraged by the current administration about the need for infrastructure investment and the need for greater focus on infrastructure from a public policy perspective. And in particular, the United States is still learning from other developed nations. But I'd like to see a lot more emphasis on public-private partnerships and the rollout of that.
I think there are three things that can be done to better fund infrastructure in Asia. I think the first one is that Asian countries need to, I think, do a better job of explaining the investment opportunities in their countries to investors outside the region. I think really what we need to see is a better education program for institutional investors by governments about the opportunity set in their country and why it makes sense for that country to be a destination for their capital. I think the second thing they need to do is often provide more incentives and share more of the risk in the infrastructure projects between the public sector and the private sector. And once you have those proof of concepts and give investors confidence, normally what happens is you can start to relax some of those incentive programs because there becomes more capital interested in those markets than actually projects available. I think the third thing that would be helpful is for governments and for local developers to be more realistic about what makes sense for institutional, private, international capital to invest in versus what makes sense for government to do.
There's been a lot of infrastructure activity in Australia over the last few years. But the reality is that it's been primarily driven by the asset recycling programs in the states of New South Wales and Victoria, which have been assisted by federal government incentives. Importantly, in both those states, the governments have committed to use many of the proceeds from those asset recycling into new infrastructure projects. So government actually assisting in the funding of new infrastructure, and that's fantastic. But the real challenge for all of us is that infrastructure is not about the next 2 to 3 years. It's about the next 10 to 20, 30 years. It's about the next generation.
In bringing private capital in, that brings with it a very significant responsibility for infrastructure managers, in the sense that infrastructure investments are not just about achieving a financial return for the investors, but they also carry with them a very significant responsibility to the communities that they serve. And so having a social awareness with respect to both the communities that you're serving and the environment that you're impacting upon is also a very important component of infrastructure investing.